Welcome everyone, this is me Sujit Kumar and I am your maths faculty. Before starting the lecture, I would like to share my profile with you. My name is Sujit Kumar. I have done BTech in electrical engineering and I also have 2 years of work experience in Tata Consultancy Services and my designation was ASE, means Assistant System Engineer. Today I am going to teach you vectors. And this is from the basic and from the start. So as you can see in the slide, what is the vector and what is scalar? There are certain physical quantities, okay, which has the numerical value alone, such like they have only magnitudes, just like our mass, the prices. Such quantities are called nothing but scalars, okay. They don't have any kind of directions. But if we give certain direction with the magnitude, it becomes what? Vectors. This is the point. Okay. This is the basic distinction between vectors and scalar. There are also other things, but we can understand with this. Hope you have understood. These are the direction. Okay. For the vector. Means it is having certain magnitude, 3 meter per second. You may see 1 meter per second, 2.5 meter per second and 1 meter per second. These are nothing but magnitude. As you know, per meter per second is the unit of what? Speed, you know. But if we give certain directions, such like in this arrow, you can see it is moving in that way. It is moving in that way. It is moving upward. So what is this? It has some direction. So if the certain physical quantity which has the direction as well as magnitude, we call this as nothing but vector. Okay, this is the basic definition. Next slide. See, all kinds of physical quantities, now we have the definition, which has both magnitude and direction and which can be added according to the triangle rule. See, this is the compulsory thing. Okay, I will tell you about this, why it is so, are called the vector quantities. This is the basic definition that you should write in your exam. Okay, the physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction and which can be added according to the triangle rule are called vectors. Okay, other example of vector are, you may know, force, momentum, electric field, magnetic field and so on. There are so many others. Okay, you may know. See, now why are we emphasizing for the triangle rule? Because there are certain quantity which is also direction as well as magnitude, just like current. Okay, but they are not vectors because they do not follow triangle rule of addition. They follow algebraic rule. Just because of this, we have added second thing also with the vector. Got the point? Okay, now next, move to the next slide. See, the vectors are denoted by you know, an arrow. Okay, even you can give the bold. Okay, as you can see in the last, we have emphasized the letter in the bold. Okay, or you can give the arrow. Okay, this is the basic notation for the vectors. Okay, and with this you can also understand there are certain books which follow the convention by darkening it. Okay, so hopefully you have understood how to symbolize a vector. Are you okay? Yep. Now I would like to conclude this small lecture. The rest part will be continued in my next series. Okay, and if you have still any doubt, then you can comment me on the inbox. And if you want to know further about me, you can know. This is my social profile. Thank you friends and happy Diwali.